This is what used to be Ali's studio and has lovely, lovely sea green walls. The ceiling is missing, as you saw in that time lapse. We're working on demolishing a chimney over here. The other part of that on the roof was already taken out and we replaced it with new material.
One of the biggest areas of change has been over here in the bathroom. Obviously you can see this wall has been removed. I have to take the top plate out yet so that we're basically gonna build a new wall along this former plaster and then into the bathroom side. So I have to take this stud out here, and then there's gonna be a new wall running all along this and then going all the way to the ceiling so that we can add insulation there. So yeah, the bathroom is basically going to get much bigger. So this wall right over here is going to extend down all the way over. And so this whole space then will be part of the bathroom. So there's going to be a shower back in this corner. There'll be a tub between these two windows. You'll probably notice that the two windows are not at the same height. So the one that was in the studio and the one that was in the bathroom are two different heights. So this window over here is going to be eliminated, and basically I'm going to move it from that position into this position, and then we'll take the small one out. So that project will probably have to wait for slightly warmer weather, but my main goal is to get this new wall up and insulated. I want to get the ceiling insulated. I have to put some electrical and plumbing in there first. But that was our main goal, was to primarily keep the squirrels and bats out. I don't know if you can see up here, there's a hole in the side where there used to be like a pipe running into that chimney. But then up here, I don't know if I can zoom in or not. Yeah, maybe. Okay, you can kind of see if it'll focus. Please focus. All right, guess not. Anyway, at the top of those bricks, they kind of taper off. That was just a hole that was up in the attic. So basically like squirrels, bats, whatever could come down that chimney, and then they had free run of this whole attic space. You can actually see this pink insulation used to continue all the way to the left side, and one of those creatures basically removed a whole bunch of it and transported it down to this end where I found it all bundled up against the chimney on top of the ceiling. So yeah, that has been a real adventure trying to get rid of these critters. The plan then for this wall behind me is basically to strip it down to the bricks, much like we did on the other side of this door. You can kind of see that it's stripped down to the bricks with the wood beams in between. We're going to do the same look, basically continuing down. This door is going to be eliminated, and so it'll be exposed brick all the way down then. And then that chimney is going to be eliminated so that the brick just continues, and then that will someday be the entrance into her new studio. That's the plan. Thank you. needed this hole drilled through the wall. This represents where the vent for the tub drain is going to go. So basically this is going to be the center line, somewhere about 18 inches out from that wall is where the tub drain will be, kind of where that hole saw is on the drill. And then that's going to run back, and then there'll be a piece of pipe that runs through this gap all the way up the wall then into the ceiling, and eventually it'll tie over into that plumbing vent there. So I needed to run this, drill this hole first, and then I'm going to put studs on either side of it. It's going to be a little bit different framing. You'll see why in a second. We're basically going to frame out above the tub little like inset wall boxes on either side of this plumbing vent. And that's going to give us the option then to like store, you know, shampoo or soap or whatever we want to, like in those spaces in the wall versus like having it on the edge of the tub where it's always falling off. So I had to do this first, and then there'll be a stud on either side of it. So let's get those in. To end it there for today, because I am actually out of short lumber. The boards I have down here are the exact right height for studs, so I don't necessarily want to cut those, but this is kind of the idea. So right above the tub there'll be these two pockets with the vent pipe that runs up through the middle gap, then that'll be hidden, but those two pockets will be for like soaps and shampoos or whatever. They'll be built into the wall, and then it'll be tile sort of all around those. So yeah, this is kind of the structure. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. There'll be a stud down in the bottom portion of that as well. This window I can't quite frame around yet because it's gonna be swapped with that window. But I'll be able to do a couple more studs over in that brick area to the left of that. And then I can do the studs to the right of this window. But if I don't cut this off now, this video will not come out in time because it's basically due out today and I'm recording it today. So I'm gonna go take a break, edit this, and get it out.